I'm going to explain how to use the interactive simulation for a temperature mole fraction plot for solid liquid equilibrium. Given the location here on the Wolfram demonstration project for this interactive simulation, but let me describe a little bit what's involved. We're plotting temperature versus mole fraction, and then on the right side we have a bar graph that represents how much of each phase we have. And so this point here can represent a mixture of solid A. So this is A, this is pure B over here. Solid A plus this compound, its overall mole fraction is 0.6 A2B3, and liquid in equilibrium. And so this is a eutectic point. This is also a eutectic point. It's the lowest melting temperature over a composition range. If we're at that composition, all the melting occurs at one temperature. So if we were to start here and raise the temperature when we got to about 200 C, we go from solid, and remember the solids are two solids, one solid's composed of microcrystals of two solids, to a liquid phase. Likewise, if we start over here with two solids, solid B plus the compound, and raise the temperature, we get to this temperature of about 300 centigrade, we would go to liquid at that one temperature. So the interactive simulation allows you to change the mole fraction of B by moving this slider. It also allows you to change the heat added. In other words, you can sit at a temperature and then add additional heat and watch which phases are formed. So now let's go and look at this interactive simulation. So here's the interactive simulation, and what I want to do is I can move this mole fraction slider, and I can fine tune the movement if I want by stepping along. I'm going to try and get close to that composition that corresponds to eutectic. So this is the eutectic point right here. So now what I'm going to do at this point, we can see on the right side we have pure A solid, and we have a solid compound, and this is the fraction of the solid that's pure A, and this is the fraction of the solid that is the compound, A2B3. As I add heat, of course the temperature increases, until I get to this eutectic temperature of 200 degrees C. Notice I've added just enough heat that I started to form some liquid on the right. As I continue to add heat at this eutectic point, the temperature doesn't change. So I'm adding heat, more liquid's forming, keep moving the slider to the right, I keep making more liquid. Both solids are disappearing to form this liquid because I picked a eutectic composition, so the overall solid composition is the same as this liquid composition, so both solids are disappearing. And as I continue to add heat, until all the solid disappears, the temperature doesn't change. And so if I step along slowly, you can see both solids are disappearing and I'm making more and more liquid. I'll get to the point where solids are gone. And now as I continue to add heat, the temperature keeps increasing and we have just pure liquid. That was eutectic point. There's another eutectic point here where the same behavior happens, except, and let's reset and let's look at that other point. So notice now we have two phases. So I've selected now a mole fraction that's approximately at the eutectic composition. You can see we have pure B and the compound equilibrium. I'm going to use the play button here where we're going to continuously add heat. And you can watch what happens as we get to eutectic point. Notice both solid phases disappearing, the liquid forming, the temperature's not changing until all the solid disappears. And now as we continue that heat, the temperature increases. Remember, an important aspect of eutectic point is that the melting takes place at constant temperature. You can go to the Wolfram site and use this simulation, try different conditions to get a better understanding of this solid liquid phase equilibrium in eutectics.